Hello guys and welcome back to a new Industrial Foregoing tutorial, and in this episode we will take a further look to the fluid transporter. And the fluid transporter is a very cheap item, and it is created by 4 redstone dust, 1 piston, 2 lapis lazuli, 1 pity machine frame and at least 1 enderpearl. And out of this we will get 2 fluid transporters, and I will demonstrate you how the fluid transporter works with the latex processing unit. In the latex processing unit you will need two fluids. One is water and the second one is a latex. And I have 2 tanks with filled with water and latex. And now you are able to configure it like this. You need 2 item to fluid transporters, and now you can transfer fluid water from this side to this side. And it works if you right click in the center of the fluid transporter, and now you're transferring water from the tank to your latex processing unit. You can see how it works very well, and you can see the direction with the bubbles here and so on. And yeah, you can also increase your speed with some add-ons, for example a speed add-on and an efficiency add-on. And you can also look which add-ons are installed if you right click the outer rectangle of the fluid transporter. And you can see on the right corner, you can see add-on speed tier 2 and add-on efficiency tier 2. That's fine. And you can also see that we have a whitelist and blacklist system in the fluid transporter. So you can maybe say if we rebuild our latex processing unit, you can see if I install a latex bucket as a whitelisted item, that means no more water should flowing. And if we take a look at our latex processing unit, we can see that the amount is by 1500 millibuckets. That's fine. So you have set a filter to a latex bucket. And yeah, I think that's the main functions of the fluid transporter system to transport fluids over a short way. So at least the maximum distance is only 1 block. That's all to the fluid transporter. Thanks for watching and bye.